All right, reading on in chapter 3, page 47. Mr. Bailey always knew when his son needed to talk to him. It didn't have anything to do with observation or intuition, but with location. Occasionally, Mr. Bailey would get home from work and find his son sitting up in the oak tree in the front yard with a contemplative look on his face. "Connor," Mr. Bailey would ask, approaching the tree, "is everything okay, bud?" "Uh-huh," Connor would mumble. "Are you sure?" Mr. Bailey would ask. "Yep," Connor would say unconvincingly. He wasn't as vocal about his troubles as his sister was, but you could see it in his face. Mr. Bailey would climb up the tree and have a seat on the branch next to him and coax out what was troubling him. "Are you sure you don't want to talk about it?" Mr. Bailey would continue. "Did something happen at school today?" Connor would nod his head. "I got a bad grade on a test," he admitted on one occasion. "Did you study for it?" his father asked. "Yes," Connor said. "I studied really hard, Dad, but it's just no use. I'll never be as smart as Alex." His cheeks turned bright red with embarrassment. "Connor, let me fill you in on something that took a long time to learn," Mr. Bailey said. "The women in your life are going to seem smarter. It's just the way it is. I've been married to your mother for 13 years, and I still have trouble keeping up with her. You can't compare yourself to others." "But I'm dumb, Dad," Connor said, his eyes filling with tears. "I find that hard to believe," Mr. Bailey said. "It takes intelligence to be funny and tell a good joke, and you're the funniest kid I know." "Humor doesn't help with history or math," Connor said. "It doesn't matter how hard I try in school, I'm always going to be the dumb kid in class." Connor's face went white and expressionless. He stared off into nothing, so ashamed of himself that it hurt. Luckily for him, Mr. Bailey had an encouraging story for every situation. "Connor, have I ever told you the legend about the walking fish?" Mr. Bailey asked him. He looked up at his father. "The walking fish?" Connor asked. "Dad, no offense, but I don't think one of your stories is going to make me feel better this time." "All right, suit yourself," Mr. Bailey said. A few moments passed and Connor's curiosity got the best of him. "Okay, you can tell me about the walking fish," Connor said. Mr. Bailey's eyes lit up as they always did just before he was going to tell a story. Connor could tell this was going to be a good one. "Once upon a time, there was a large fish who lived in a lake by himself," Mr. Bailey told him. "Every day, the fish would watch longingly as a boy from the village nearby would play with all the horses and dogs and squirrels on land." "Is the dog going to die in this story, Dad?" Connor interrupted. "You know I hate stories where the dogs die." "Let me finish," Mr. Bailey went on. "One day, a fairy came to the land and granted the fish a wish." "Well, that's random," Connor said. "Why do fairies always just show up and do nice things for people they don't know?" "An employment obligation?" Mr. Bailey shrugged. "But for argument's sake, let's say she dropped her wand in the lake and the fish retrieved it, so she offered him a wish as a thank you. Are you happy?" "That's better," Connor said. "Go on." "The fish predictably wished for legs so he could play with the boy from the village," Mr. Bailey said. "So the fairy turned his fins into legs and he became the walking fish." "Well, that's weird," Connor said. "Let me guess, the fish was so freaky looking, the boy never wanted to play with him." "Nope. They became great friends and played together with the other land animals," Mr. Bailey told him. "But one day, the boy fell into the lake and couldn't swim. The walking fish tried to save him, but it was no use. He didn't have fins anymore. Sadly, the boy drowned." Connor's mouth hung open like a broken glove compartment. "You see, if the fish had just stayed in the lake and not wished to be something else, he could have saved the boy's life," Mr. Bailey finished. "Dad, that's a horrible story," he said. "How does a boy live by a lake and not know how to swim? Dogs can swim. Couldn't one of them have saved him? Where was that fairy when the boy was drowning?" "I think you're missing the point of the story," Mr. Bailey said. "Sometimes we forget about our own advantages before we focus on what we don't have. Just because you have to work a little harder at something that seems easier to others doesn't mean that you're without your own talents." Connor thought about this for a moment. "I think I get it, Dad," he said. Mr. Bailey smiled at him. "Now, why don't you get down from this tree and I'll help you study for your next test?" "I told you, studying doesn't help," Connor said. "I've tried and tried and tried. It never helps." "Then we'll come up with our own way of studying, Mr. Bailey told him. We'll look at the pictures of people in your history book and make up jokes about them, and you'll remember their names. And we'll create funny scenarios to help you with all of the math formulas. Connor slowly but surely nodded and agreed to it. Fine, he said with half a smile. But for future reference, I liked your story about the curvy tree much better.